Well, well, here's the other volcano coming to make things worse. You should be scared, as the scientist has a warning for all of us. Are you prepared to face the wrath of nature's dormant giants? Don't miss our eye-opening exploration of these volcanic marvels and the startling secrets they hold. A supervolcano in Italy that has been dormant for a very long time is drawing closer to the point where it could erupt for the first time since 1538, according to a new study, and the results could be extremely disastrous. The crust of the Campi Flegrei volcano, which is located near Naples in southern Italy, is weakening and growing more prone to rupturing, which makes an eruption more likely, according to the experts who conducted a new study on the subject. Over 1.5 million people make their homes above the large underground volcano complex, and another 500,000 people live within its 7-mile-long caldera, which was formed following a massive eruption 39,000 years ago. Together, these two populations make up over 2 million people. If Campi Flegrei were to repeat its most powerful previous eruption, it would send molten rock and volcanic gases high into the stratosphere, unleash tsunamis as high as 100 feet, and spread a plume of sulfur and toxic ash that could plunge the Earth into a global winter for years, resulting in the destruction of crops and the extinction of a large number of species. The findings of the investigation were presented in a paper that was published on June 9 in the journal Communications Earth and Environment. Our new study confirms that Campi Flegrei is moving closer to rupture. Christopher Kilburn, a professor at Earth Science at University College London and the study's lead author, said in a statement about the findings. On the other hand, he did offer a word of caution, saying that this does not mean that an eruption is guaranteed. A fissure may be created in the crust as a result of the rupture, but for an eruption to take place, the magma must first be moving upward at the appropriate position. Campi Flegrei, which translates to burning fields or fiery fields, is a huge, mostly hidden network of 24 craters and edifices that spreads from its vast caldera opposite Vesuvius at the western border of Naples into the surrounding Gulf of Puteoli. The name Campi Flegrei means burning fields or fiery fields. Even though Campi Flegrei is frequently characterized as a supervolcano, this has not been verified to a satisfactory degree. Supervolcanoes are types of volcanoes that are capable of producing eruptions of the highest magnitude, which is an 8 on the Volcano Explosivity Index. As a result of these eruptions, supervolcanoes can eject more than 240 cubic miles of material. However, Campi Flegrei's largest eruption ever released as much as 70 cubic miles of material, making it a Category 7 eruption, which is still considered extremely dangerous. Fluorine is one of the dangerous chemical components that could be released into the atmosphere as a result of the eruption. If fluorine is present in high enough concentrations, it is capable of causing the sickness known as fluorosis in animals as well as killing vegetation. Since the middle of the 20th century, the volcano has been showing signs of unrest, with periods of increased activity occurring in the 1950s, 70s, and 80s. Another phase of unrest began in the last decade and is currently ongoing. During this period, the ground below Pozzoli, a town built on the volcano's roof, has risen by 4 inches each year, which has resulted in a total change in elevation of 13 feet since the 1950s. This period of unrest began when the earth below Pozzoli began rising by 4 inches each year. In addition, Campi Flegrei is witnessing a steady stream of minor earthquakes, with over 600 having been identified in April alone, exceeding its previous record for the highest monthly total ever recorded in the region. According to experts, the underground fermentation is most likely caused by volcanic gas seeping into the crust approximately 2 miles below the surface of Campi Flegrei, which then acts as a sponge to absorb the gas. This results in the crust stretching, warping, and slipping, which in turn causes earthquakes to occur on the surface. If there is enough volcanic gas that seeps into the crust, the heat and pressure that it generates can push the rocks beyond what is known as critical degassing pressure, causing the rocks to fracture and create a fissure through which the magma below can escape during an eruption. The researchers coupled seismic data with measures of ground uplift to create estimations of the changing tensile strength of the region's crust and its proximity to rupture. This allowed them to determine the potential likelihood of an eruption occurring in the region. According to the researchers, the crust that lies beneath Campi Flegrei is cracking rather than bending as a result of the pressure. A study, the churn of subsurface gas and magma, has been progressively stretching and weakening Campi Flegrei's crust since the 1950s. This has resulted in its tensile strength being reduced to barely a third of what it was in 1984. This indicates that even while the earthquakes in the region are not as powerful as they were in the 1980s, the weaker rock can rupture under lower forces. As a result, seismologists have fewer earthquakes to detect, and people have less time to flee before the shaking starts. Despite this, geologists insist that it does not follow that a massive eruption is about to take place. For volcanoes to erupt, gases need to accumulate at a rate that is higher than the rate at which they can escape, and magma also has to be able to travel quickly through the crust in an area where a crack is formed. Scientists are unable to determine whether or not these two requirements have been met until an eruption has taken place. The same can be said for the scale of the prospective eruption of Campi Flegrei, which is difficult to forecast, but according to the experts is much more likely to be modest than it is to be enormous. It's the same for any volcanoes that have been calm for several years or even centuries. Stefano Carlino, a researcher at the Vesuvius Observatory, was quoted in the statement as saying, "Campi Flegrei may settle into a new routine of gently rising and subsiding, as seen at similar volcanoes around the world, or simply return to rest. At this point, we are unable to predict the future with absolute certainty. It is essential to make sure that you are well prepared for any eventuality." And speaking of volcanic activity, there was another significant eruption of the Hunga Tonga Hunga Ha Apai undersea volcano near Tonga in 2022. According to a study published in Science Advances, the 2022 eruption of the Hunga Tonga Hunga Ha Apai undersea volcano was larger than any natural explosion from the previous century or even any nuclear explosion in the U.S. Although the Tongan volcanic explosion in the Southwest Pacific resulted in 4 fatalities, it is comparable to the enormous Krakatoa volcanic eruption near Indonesia in 1883 that claimed more than 36,000 lives. Sam Perkis, a marine geoscientist at the University of Miami and the study's principal author, asserted that a hydrogen bomb is the only device that could produce an explosion of this size. In terms of human experience, this is way off the charts of anything. The researchers built a simulation of the eruption and ensuing tsunami waves using satellite data, field observations, and drone mapping to give a new in-depth perspective of the explosive event. They discovered that tsunami waves might reach heights of up to 17 meters on Tongatapau, the nation's most populous island, and the location of its capital, Nuku'alofa, and up to 45 meters on Tofua Island in Tonga. The study also demonstrated how the tsunami could have been substantially worse while still causing significant damage. Researchers have discovered various records that were attained during the eruption on January 15, 2022. It caused a record-breaking amount of water vapor to be discharged into the atmosphere, enough to fill 58,000 swimming pools, which could briefly warm the temperature in the years to come. By ejecting ash 36 miles into the atmosphere, it broke the previous record for the tallest volcano plume recorded by satellites, going beyond what many scientists had thought physically possible. At 720 miles per hour, it produced the Earth's fastest airwaves, which at least 6 times around the planet. Co-author Shane Cronin from the University of Auckland traveled there with his colleagues a few weeks following the eruption to assess the ground's devastation. They discovered downed trees and plants high along the coast by scaling mountainsides and utilizing drone photos. "For the first time now, we can confirm on the ground that this happened," said Perkis, chief scientist at the Khaled bin Sultan Living Oceans Foundation, who also helped collect data on the underwater terrain for the model. "It's a singular event in modern history." On January 15, witnesses in Nuku'alofa, which is around 40 miles from the undersea volcano, reported hearing 2 booms just before 5 o'clock local time. Within 30 minutes, plumes started to cover the island like an umbrella. Perkis stated that these 2 blasts were likely modest and did not cause any significant tsunami despite the booms and apparent plume. Then, there were 2 more considerably louder booms. This time, the blasts caused destructive tsunami waves to hit Nuku'alofa's western coast and city center. The 5th and most potent bomb then detonated. The scientists calculated the strength of the final blast wave to be 15 megatons, or the equivalent of 15 million tons of TNT, using simulations and pressure changes measured from smashed windows on neighboring islands. That roughly equates to the biggest nuclear test carried out by the U.S. The recent explosion was so powerful that it physically moved significant volumes of seawater, resulting in an enormous local tsunami. According to Perkis, if you were in the blast's theoretical epicenter when it happened, you would have been standing on a dry seabed. According to the simulation, the displaced wave was 85 meters high 1 minute after the blast, which is mind-boggling and hard to believe, he said. The wave was 45 meters tall when it arrived at Tofua Island in Tonga, according to the team's ground observations, though Perkis suggested the estimate might be conservative. The crew discovered that the shallower waters closer to the beach were crucial in slowing and calming the waves. The water drags along the ocean floor as it flows toward the coast, slowing it down. The same explanation explains why large surf waves farther out in the ocean don't knock us off our feet. The waves from each blow circled in the shallow water, slowing as they approached the platforms of the coral reef one by one. Perkis, however, said that the waves from the many blasts converged and prolonged the tsunami risk. Perkis claimed that the most potent explosion was caused by seawater leaking into the heated magma and erupting, which resulted in a steam-generated eruption. The first four explosions likely broke the rocks, allowing a significant amount of water to enter the magma chamber and produce the enormous fifth explosion. Other experts have proposed theories as to what caused the succession of blasts to occur, which this new study does not address. A magma hammer, or magma surging up and striking the volcano before repeatedly falling back down onto the magma chamber, is what volcanologist Melissa Scruggs and her colleagues propose. According to Scruggs, the greatest eruption's seismic record shows a quick pressure drop that led to the magma's sudden surge. Scruggs, a researcher at the University of California, Santa Barbara, stated in an email that this seismic signature isn't common for volcanic eruptions and has never been described before. Our scientific instruments have never detected such a trace, the statement continues. This is not to suggest it has never happened. Scruggs also notes that although the volcano started erupting in December, experts are unsure of what first set it off. This is what volcanoes do, Perkis added. He claimed that sometimes they spring to life and the magma inside the beast's plumbing begins to move. Dan Slayback, another co-author, expressed surprise at simply how an event of such magnitude can appear with little apparent warning. Since December 2021, smaller eruptions have been taking place, but by mid-January, they had calmed down. NASA research scientist Slayback stated, "I don't think anyone particularly foresaw the Big Bang on January 15." He described the eruption as occurring in this area once every 500 years. Perkis claimed that given the event's size and length, the death toll could have been far higher, similar to Krakatoa. But he gives the community's swift action and the region's low visitor traffic as a result of the coronavirus outbreak credit. Additionally, it occurred throughout the day, while people were out and about. Additionally, Tonga's capital city is shielded from approaching tsunamis by an island in a lagoon. Although this was an extremely severe incident, Krakatoa will remain in people's memories. Perkis argued that this was a good thing. The study did exceptional work moving the research on the 2022 local tsunami forward, according to coastal engineer Ignacio Sepulveda Oyarzun, who was not engaged in the study. He praised the authors for using citizen reports of explosions, plume timing, and broken glass to limit the model. Sepulveda Oyarzun, a professor at San Diego State University, has been researching the mechanism of even further-reaching tsunami waves from the volcanic eruption, which resulted in two deaths in Peru and damage as far away as California and New Zealand. "I did not know about the tsunamigenic potential of a possible fifth blast," he said. The effort for understanding volcanic-induced tsunamis extend beyond Tonga, since 1883 for the Krakatoa tsunami, he said. That's all for the video today. We will be right back with more. Don't forget to hit the like button and subscribe to our channel.